beautiful job. And we thank God for them and the songs that they sang. And we thank God for all that have made their way in the house of the Lord. We're going to ask you to get your Bibles and turn to the first chapter of Romans, the 18th verse. Romans 1, 18. We're glad to see those that have been absent for a while.
Amen.
Back in church.
Amen.
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 The Lord is good.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I hope y'all don't wait till the Lord shake you up a little bit before you start running back to church. Now, God knows how to shake you up. He knows how to shake you. Romans 1, 18. For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. Because that which may be known of God is manifest in them. For God has showed it unto them. For the invisible things of Him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even His eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse.
All right.
Because that when they knew God, they glorified Him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish hearts was darkened. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your kindness. We thank you for your love. We thank you for blessing us. We thank you for giving us strength this morning. We thank you for blessing us to arise out of our bed. Lord, we know that sometimes things get in our way and we can't seem to push them aside in order to do that which is pleasing in thy sight. We're asking you, Lord, to bless this day. Bless those, O Lord, who are unable to make it into the house of the Lord. And we're asking you to move those obstacles in the name of Jesus. Lord, it's you. Especially for our young people. Move those obstacles, Lord. Bless them to know that without you, they would not be who they are. So bless now, Lord, and let your spirit abide. Grant us power to glorify and magnify your name. Bless the word this morning, Lord, and draw us nigh to thee, we pray. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
All God's people say it.
Amen.
Again, we thank God for all those in the house of the Lord. We thank God for those two that went down in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Monday night.
Yes.
In prayer.
Amen.
I just can't remember your last names right now.
Jones.
Both Jones, right?
Amen.
The sister and sister Jones.
Amen.
They went down in Jesus' name on Monday night in prayer.
Amen.
You know, everybody don't always understand when the preaching comes. So it's good that we sometimes have to sit down and explain.
Amen.
But you got to understand that when you go down in Jesus' name, you're starting a new life.
Yes, sir.
You can't go and do the same old thing that you used to do.
That's right.
That's a bad thing to do. You don't want God to cut you off in your mess.
That's right.
Amen.
Especially after He brought you to the truth.
That's right.
Amen.
It's going to be worse in hell for those who knew the truth and didn't live by it than for those who never knew the truth. Can you imagine meeting one of your friends in hell and you tell them you could have missed this because you knew about the baptism in Jesus' name and being filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost? But you didn't do what you were supposed to do, and you didn't tell them. Can you imagine what they're going to do to you? Come on now.
All right. That's right. That's right.
Can you imagine what they're going to do to you in hell? Lord have mercy. They're going to say, you had the opportunity, and you could have kept me from coming here.
Yeah, come on, right. Hallelujah.
It's going to be a sad situation.
Yes, sir.
But we ask, Vince said, we have things to do today. Sister Hope is invited this afternoon to preach.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. And she has a servant.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. She is on a panel, is that what it is? That she's going to be on, and we want to support her.
Amen.
Every time you go to church, you find Sister Hope
Amen.
On the organ. And you feel that's just where she ought to be.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, have mercy.
Thank you, Lord.
You all don't know how much it costs to have an organist.
Mm-hmm.
You have no idea what organists are asking just to come and play a couple of hours on Sunday. They're asking big money.
Mm-hmm.
They're asking big money. I've had them come in here and want us to hire them as organs. They don't care how large the congregation is. They got nothing to do with what they want. But see, I don't want anyone that's officiating in the church that don't want to know about Jesus.
Right.
That don't want to know about his name. They just want to come and play. And then soon they're through, they're out the door. I don't need them. I don't need them. I might as well go ahead and use my voice and sing melodious.
Melodious.
Whatever it is.
Melodious.
And make you jump and shout.
Amen.
Now, how did you mean it? But the Lord is good. We thank God for Sister Hope.
Amen.
The organ, and she doesn't complain. I see her sometimes grabbing her hands because they cramp. You all just don't understand Sister Hope's vintage.
Thank you, Lord.
You don't understand her vintage. Most of those that's her age and playing the organ or piano, they're packing. Come on now. Sister Hope is playing the organ, and she plays well, and I thank God for that. Thank God for all of you that made your way this morning in the house of the Lord. I want you to remember, I understand Sister Deja's grandmother passed away. Is that right? Sister Deja's grandmother passed away. Won't you pray for her and remember the Ferguson family and the loss of their mother, that the Lord will certainly bless their mother and grandmother, that the Lord will bless their and give comfort and give strength, and that knowledge may come to them as to who Jesus is. We're happy to see all of the saints in the house of the Lord. Now, we want to go to Romans where it says, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. God has sent the truth, but everybody don't want it. God has sent the truth. He continues to send it, but everybody don't want it. And they care less about getting it. But it doesn't matter. One of the things that I notice as I read God's word is the parallel that our country is going in. when I say that, this country, not that it has been on the right road, but they did start out to try to find God as to what is truth. That is, when they were in England and the other European countries, they were commanded to worship in a certain way.
Yes, yes.
And if they did not worship in what they call Christianity, they were persecuted. They were persecuted for not worshiping God as they were commanded to worship God. Give me just a little bit more volume on this particular mic. They were told how they could worship God. And then they came to America. And when they came to America, they said it was for religious freedom.
That's right.
That they could worship God in the way that they saw fit. But even then, things did not go as they ought to go.
Right.
But God has blessed America in so many ways. You had the opportunity to find truth. You had the opportunity to become acquainted with truth on your own. Now in Salem, I think it's Massachusetts in New England, what they called the church at that time, and what they call the church today, the Catholic Church, persecuted the saints of God. They told them they were chanting and they were chirping. And they said all manner of things against the church.
Hallelujah.
When in fact, it was the church was receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Right.
And because they did not want to receive what the scripture says, but they received what a man said.
Yeah,
they put the saints of God to death
right
here in America.
Yeah, right.
And those days are sliding back into existence.
Right.
Before I go further, I want to stop and give accolades to one that has done well about the church. I meant to bring what I was supposed to bring the church, but Ashley didn't take care of business. Sister Dunn has done a great job.
Yeah.
Does it look good out front?
Yes.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
And we have also done great work in the back.
All right. All right.
We thank God for that.
Yes.
Now, we didn't tell her to do it free. But when one works in church, they also should be compensated.
That's right.
For what they do.
Amen.
Now we can't compensate everybody in church for every little thing that they do. Because you all don't break all the ties into the storehouse. That there may be meat in mine. I know y'all say all that money goes to Elder Hope. Amen. all that money going to the preacher. And you just can't look around and see what needs to be done in church and what it would take to get you to do it would be what?
Money.
You say, why ain't this done? Why don't you have that? Why don't they do this? But how much money did you leave? Did you even pay the tithing that God instructed you to pay? Amen? So when you start thinking about what the church should do, the church should help the poor. Amen?
Amen.
The church should help the poor, right?
Amen.
What should you do? What should you be doing? Amen? I heard politicians speak of the church helping the poor, but they don't want the people to have a job so that they can bring money to the church. They're sending all the money overseas. They're getting paid to send it overseas. And so they're not worried about you. When you vote, think before you vote. Amen? They're trying to block you from voting. They're trying to cut you out now. And if you're not paying attention, you will vote for the wrong ones. And they will have your city, and you will be the slave in your city. I don't even think y'all even understand what I'm talking about. Those outside the city want to come back to the city.
That's right. That's right.
They're tired of the suburban living.
That's right.
And they want to come back, but they want to send you to the suburbs.
Right.
Amen? Amen? And many of us are just about gone. Many of us are just about gone and don't even realize that that's their objective, is to move you out of the city so that they can come back. If you don't believe me, go downtown and look. Get out of the house, right around your city, and see what they are doing. I know on television, they always show you the burned down, vacant houses. They never show you the new buildings that they're building. Come on now.
That's right.
The new lofts that they're building.
That's right.
The new housing that they're building in the city of Detroit.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And it's not for you.
That's right.
It's not for you. They want you to come and take their own places.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Amen?
Amen.
They want you out of the city. So be careful when you vote.
Amen.
Be careful who you put in there.
That's right.
There is an election coming up in November. November 6th. It's not a presidential election, but it's just as important. It is a mayor election. Who are you going to put in as your mayor? There's one that is getting backed up with a lot of money. Now you know it's not coming from Detroit.
All
right. Oh, y'all hate this. He's being backed up with a lot of money. Now, why would they back him up with a lot of money to be mayor of Detroit?
Take it over.
Think about it.
Right.
They don't love you.
Right.
They don't even like you.
That's right.
So you got to be careful. They talk sweet.
Yes.
But under their tongue, is contrite AIDS. Y'all probably don't know what contrite AIDS is. That's in the Bible. Be careful of who you put in your mayor spot. You didn't go out to vote, and you got a governor that you don't even like. Amen? A governor that doesn't like you even. He doesn't like you, and they're the just because they put a one of you in as emergency manager doesn't mean that they like you. It just means that he really gets paid. He really gets paid, and guess who pays him? The city of Detroit. Oh, y'all ain't listening. You all are so laid back and so happy. Wake up, Detroit. That was free. But the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. And as I was saying, I see a parallel with what is happening in our country. Men are denying God. And they're not so much denying God with their verbiage, more with the way that they are acting. But the problem is not them that they're denying God. It is the saints of God. When the saints of God begin to fall into the trap of the enemy because they are looking at what is going on in the world. And they are taken by what is happening in the world. The church begins to complain against God. They began to complain about what they do not have. They began to complain and say that it is the church's fault that they do not have. And I can look and see why many would complain against what they call the church. But those that complain against the church has never looked to see what the mega churches are doing. Because that is where they are complaining against the church as to what they call the church. They have never inquired as to what makes up the church. They've only taken what they think is the church and never took time to figure out what is the church. They like the scam artists. The scam artist is taking all of your money. And they're flying around in jets. Their own private jet. They have acres of land. Whereas you got to pass so many gates to get to them. And if you want to talk to them, you better have some money in your pocket. You better be somebody of great stature to get nigh them. Whereas when God sent someone to talk to you and has sent them, where you can reach them, then you begin to judge them by the scam artists. And you put them in the same category and begin to speak of them in the same manner. But when you see the scam artists, you begin to give them accolades because they have so much money and they have so much influence. Many folks are taken with Billy Graham. Yet Billy Graham has not told anybody in all his years as to what salvation is all about. There's one that's today who is very popular, and they're not telling anybody about salvation. The plan of salvation is well known and not known all at the same time. If you think that I'm crazy, all you have to do, if you can get to them and tell them and show them according to scripture what it takes to be saved, and they will usher you quickly out of their presence. They will block you from ever getting again to the position that you had gotten to when you could speak to them personally. But God said, the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness of men. You're wondering, Lord have mercy. I got to slow down. You're wondering about homosexuality and the passing of laws that is allowing homosexuals to marry of the same gender, male with male, female with female. There are some on television, some of the commentators, two females who've had a baby. Now you know, two females can't have a baby. So they've gotten it by artificial insemination. And they're on television. They're commentators on a very popular television station. And they're getting accolades for being a couple that is having a baby. And here you are with the knowledge of the truth, and you're complaining against the church that will tell you the truth, that will show you what the Bible has to say about salvation. But you're so upset with the church progressing. Your mind is blinded. Even when God speaks to you, even when he makes it plain in your mind, it's time to wake up out of darkness. It's time that we put on our garments, saints. It's time for us to wrap ourselves up in the beauty of holiness. It's time for us to put the joy of salvation on. Our God is soon to come. It won't be long. before Jesus get here. All the signs. Lord have mercy. Are coming together. As it was in the days of Sodom and Gomorrah. So shall it be in the day of the coming of the Lord. It's all coming together. We're getting busy on our jobs. We're getting busy doing everything but serving God. We're getting busy doing everything but checking out the word of God. Wake up, saints. Wake up the holiness. Wake up the truth.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. It's time for us to wake up the truth. Because the enemy is rocking you to sleep. Doing your thing. While God is on his way back, you're doing your thing. You're talking about having a good time. And none of what you will do will get you out of here.
Right.
When the Lord comes. You've been doing it. And you got tired of doing it. You're coming to holiness. God shows you a new way. And then the devil begins to remind you of what you used to do. And make you feel what you used to feel when you were on the floor. Glory, hallelujah. When you sat at the bar cussing everybody out, doing your thing, and he makes you forget. Glory, hallelujah. How you got tired of that sin. How you became upset with that sin. And you knew something was missing. And God began to show you his grace and his mercy. God began to show you the great beauty that he has prepared for us. Glory, hallelujah. Jesus, help us today. Guide us today, Lord. God is fixing it up. It's time to get ourselves together and get ready for our long white road. It's time to get ready so that we can march into glory. I know all things turn to Peter, 2 Peter, and the 3rd chapter. Thank you, Jesus. 2 Peter, I got to slow down. I get carried away. Thank you, Jesus. So I got to talk. Glory, hallelujah. Second Peter, 3rd chapter. Start at the first verse. Just go.
This second epistle.
An epistle is a letter. It is a letter that Paul wrote to the church. Read.
This second epistle, beloved. I now write unto you. In both which I stir up.
Your pure mind by the way of remembrance. He says, I want you to remember. I want you to understand. Now Peter is talking to the church, causing them to realize what has gone forth. Read.
That ye may be mindful. Of the words spoken before.
Which were spoken before.
By the holy prophets.
And of the commandment
of us the apostles.
Of, of the Lord and Savior. See, he's God and our Savior.
Mm-hmm.
He's God and our deliverer.
Yeah.
He's God and Jesus Christ that hung on Calvary.
Yes, sir.
Peter says, I want to stir up your pure mind.
Yes,
read.
Knowing this first,
that there shall come in the last days
scoffers
walking after their own lust. I want you to understand, unless you go to sleep in this hustling and bustling world, you can see that the signs of the time is around us. That God's word is coming to pass. And it's time for you to wake up out of sleep and get yourself ready to give praise to God. Now, if you don't want to go to heaven, you want to look at me and say the preacher is trying to scare somebody. You keep right on doing what you're doing. You have the privilege to walk the way you want to walk.
Yes, sir.
You have the privilege to do what you want to do. God has given you that privilege.
Mm-hmm.
But wait when you wake up.
Hallelujah.
Lord have mercy.
Hallelujah.
Read this note.
And sing.
Where is glory, hallelujah. The wrath of God is revealed from heaven. Folks are still. You see, they won't read about Israel. Israel also got tired of waiting for the Messiah. It was about 4,000 years that they heard that Messiah would come. They heard that God would come and visit them. For 4,000 years, it was told them the Messiah would come. And they got tired. Their children's children. And the children of those children. Say, we've been hearing that all of our lives. And they got tired of hearing it. So they wanted to be like everybody else. Glory. Hallelujah. And see, the church is getting to the same state. It's getting to the same state. Read this, though. I'm trying to get through here. And say,
where is the promise of his coming?
For since the fathers fell asleep,
all things
continue as they were
from the beginning of the creation.
They said everything remains the same.
Mm-hmm.
They said, we'll get up tomorrow morning.
Right.
The sun's going to come up like it came up on yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
People are going to talk the way they talk. They're going to do what they always do. My God. You got to understand. God is long-suffering.
Yes,
and it's good for you that he's long-suffering.
Yes,
you just don't understand that. You will in a little while. Read.
For this they willingly are ignorant of.
That by the word of God,
the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water,
and in the water,
whereby the world that then was,
being overflowed with water,
perished.
Listen, it happened in Noah's day. It happened in Noah's day. They tell me that the ark is still on the mount.
Mm-hmm.
It's still sitting there.
Mm-hmm.
You can still see it. I know you don't believe it. Because you ain't been there.
Mm-hmm.
Keep on not believing. Glory, hallelujah. Read.
But the heavens and the earth,
which are now, by the same word,
are kept in store,
reserved unto fire, against the day of judgment
and perdition
of ungodly men. God's going to bring judgment against ungodly men. I'm looking and I see that they went down to a volcano. They can only get so close with their heat resistant material. If they got any closer and they slipped and failed, there's no way to find them. They would burn to a crisp. But as I looked at the pictures that they were taking, it was bubbling like it was water. It was lava, earthly material that was just bubbling and splashing against the sides of the mountain. You think there's got to be an atom bomb or a nitro bomb? Let me tell you, the fire is already kindled. Glory, hallelujah. When God get ready to bring it out, no man can stop it. Glory,
hallelujah.
Read, Sister Hope.
But beloved,
he says, don't be a dummy. When he said don't be ignorant, he said don't be no dummy. Beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing.
That one day
is with the Lord
as a thousand years.
And a thousand years
as one day.
The Lord is not slack. The Lord is not slow. Glory, hallelujah. God's not slow. Read.
Concerning his promise.
As some men count slackness, but is long suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Read. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heaven shall pass away
with a great noise,
and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burned up. I want you to understand, God is sending a newsflash. God is sending a bulletin. Glory,
hallelujah.
Trying to wake you up. Proverbs 1. Glory, hallelujah. Proverbs 1. I think it's 22.
Yes, sir.
Read.
How long,
ye simple ones?
Will
ye love simple? What does God have to do? What does God have to do to get you to change your mind? Does he have to come? When he comes, it's too late.
Come on now. Come on.
You know, if I tell you, don't go down Plymouth, there is a large hole down Plymouth. You're subject to slide into it. So don't go down Plymouth. Go over and go out Schoolcraft instead. And I warn you. And you say, Cliff don't know what he's talking about.
Well.
And you go down Plymouth and slide in the hole.
Well.
Now whose fault is it?
Well.
You can't blame Cliff.
That's right.
You've been talking about I should. There's going to be a lot of I shoulds in hell.
Yes, sir.
Read.
How long you
suppose? Will you love simplicity?
Scorners.
And scorners.
Delight
in their scorning.
And fools hate knowledge.
And fools. That's what God called them. Hate knowledge. Read.
Turn you at my reproof.
Turn you at my reproof.
Behold. I will pour out my spirit
unto you.
I will make known my words
unto you.
Because I have called,
and ye refuse.
I have stretched out my hand,
and no man regarded. Skip to the 27th verse. 26. Read 26.
I will also laugh at your calamity.
I will mock when your fear cometh.
When your fear cometh at desolation,
and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind. When distress and anguish cometh upon you,
then shall they call upon me,
but I will not answer.
They shall seek me early,
but they shall not find me. Lord have mercy. That's what God said.
Right.
Go back to Romans, first chapter. Tell you what God does. 24th verse. I'm almost finished.
Wherefore, God also gave them up to uncleanness.
To the lust of their own hearts.
To dishonor their own bodies.
Listen. This was written in A.D. 60. But it was declared 4,000 years before now.
Right.
Over 4,000 years before now. But it's being declared here in the scriptures in AD 60. But it's coming to pass in 2013. Read.
Who changed the truth of God.
Into a lie.
Who worship and serve the creature.
More than the creator.
Who is blessed forever.
Amen.
For this cause.
God gave them up.
Unto vile affections.
That even their women. Did change the natural use.
Into that which is against nature.
Lord have mercy. Don't you see it? Don't you see it? And you're still standing back and complaining against God and His church? Read.
And likewise also the men.
Leaving the natural use of the woman.
Burned in their lust.
One toward another.
Men with men.
Working that which is unseemly.
And receiving in themselves.
That recompense of their error. Which was meet. Now. Glory. Hallelujah. They're passing a law. That these folks. Can adopt children. And when they adopt children, what do you suppose they'll teach them?
Mm-hmm.
Come on, y'all.
Right.
What do you suppose that they would tell them? Mm-hmm. Ain't nothing wrong with being with a man.
Right.
You a man. Mm-hmm. Ain't nothing wrong. Mm-hmm. This is happening.
Mm-hmm.
You're living in it.
Yes, sir.
And you still refuse God? All fools and slow of heart to believe. all that the scriptures have said. Read, Sister Hope. I'm almost finished.
Even as they did not like to retain God.
Even as they did not like to retain God
in their knowledge.
In their knowledge.
God gave them over
to a reprobate mind.
To
do those things.
Yes.
Listen. He said they weren't convenient.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Men leaving the use of a woman. Glory, hallelujah.
Yes,
they're doing it. It's coming out more and more.
Yes.
Making it more and more applicable.
Yes.
That homosexuals can present themselves and show you how abundantly they are in society.
Yes.
Making you know that your neighbor could be one. Lord have mercy. I fear to say that they'll come out in the church. Read.
Being filled with all unrighteousness.
Fornication.
Wickedness.
Covetousness.
Maliciousness.
Full of envy.
Murder.
Debate.
Deceit,
malignity,
whisperers,
backbiters,
haters
of God,
despiteful,
proud,
boasters,
inventors of evil,
disobedient
to parents,
without understanding,
covenant breakers,
without natural
affection,
implacable,
unmerciful.
Listen,
all that's happening, and you still got a complaint. Against the church. You go to the barn and they don't tell you it's coming. You go to your parties. They say, break down. Do your thing. They don't tell you the Lord is coming soon. But all of them say they're Christians. Shake your faith. It's time to wake up. You'll know it ain't right. I don't have to go around preaching what ain't right. I'm trying to tell you the truth. I'm trying to get you to live right. You already know how to live wrong. Read.
Who knowing
the judgment of God,
that they which commit such things
are worthy of death,
not only do the same,
but have pleasure in them that do. Listen, you like to hang with those folks that do offend. You like to sit down and converse with them, talk about it. Time to wake up. God is on the throne. Sin is rampant in the land. Every day, another homosexual is coming out. Whereas fornicators, you glorify them. One man taking another man's wife and going to have a baby with her. Your famous stars. Your movie stars are shacking up and having babies and glorifying. Come on now. Make you think that all that's all right. God said, wake up out of sleep. Wake up. He's coming soon. It won't be long before the Lord returns. It won't be long before Jesus come back. All things are ready for your salvation.
God is ready to deliver you. But you got to be ready to be delivered.
Yes, sir.
Some of us have been baptized, but we want to go back and do the same thing all over again. It's not to get baptized again.
Mm-hmm.
It's time to repent. It's time to get your mind right.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Wake up. Wake up. I'm 72 years old now. I have never seen sin as rampant as it is.
Yes, sir.
And as glorified as it is getting. Let me tell you this. The homosexual should not be discriminated against. Say, well, we just got to tell them. If you're going to discriminate against a homosexual,
mm-hmm.
discriminate against the fornicator.
Yes, sir.
Come on. Come on.
If you're going to cut the fornicator out, cut the murderer out.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Cut the thief off.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going back to the scriptures. I'm trying to get it short. Am I promoting homosexuality?
No.
No way. Well, let me tell you. God has told me that in the last days, it would be so. Said there'll be marrying and giving in marriage.
Mm-hmm.
I'm only trying to warn you. While you are spitting out fire against a homosexual, here you are dancing in sin. Don't you think it's time to wake up and serve the true God? There are going to be folks that's left here that know about the church. There's going to be folks that were baptized in Jesus' name but didn't see fit to learn to walk with God. They decided to continue to do as they want. The Lord said, oh fools and slow of heart. All things are ready. All things are ready. All things are ready for your salvation. You've not been baptized in Jesus' name. Now is your time. Now is your time to walk with Jesus. Now is your time to get to know God. If you're here today and you know that you need to make adjustments in your life, you need to stand to your feet right now. You need to stand to your feet saying, I need some adjustments in my life. Now see, when you come here, you got to be truthful with yourself. You got to be truthful with yourself. Don't come just because everybody else came. But be truthful to yourself. don't know if you've come just because everybody else came, or there it in your heart, you understand that you need to make adjustments in your life.
Hallelujah.
If you've come because you want to make adjustments in your life, by the power of God,
hallelujah,
God understands. And in turn, God will give you that which you have need of. He will bless you on that which you have need of. But you got to be truthful with God. You really have to present your heart and mind,
hallelujah,
to Jesus as He speaks to you.
Yes.
And in turn, God will change your life. He'll fix it. Do you love Him tonight, saints?
Yes.
Do you want His blessing?
Yes.
Then you got to commit and submit.
Thank you, Jesus.
And give yourself to the Lord. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus,
hallelujah,
we know that all power, lift your hands to the Lord,
hallelujah,
in heaven and earth,
thank you, Jesus,
is in thine hand.
Hallelujah.
It is you, Lord,
hallelujah,
that has opened up the way. It is you, Lord,
hallelujah,
that has made the way of salvation.
Thank you, Jesus.
We're asking you, even in this hour right now, to look on every heart that stands here before the altar,
hallelujah,
with their hands raised in surrender to you, Lord. You understand their needs,
hallelujah,
and you understand their hearts. Lord, we're asking you to save.
Hallelujah.
We're asking you to deliver. We're asking you to fix it, Lord. Bless these souls. Lord, help them to surrender and to commit and to turn their heart to you. Bless them. Let your blood prevail this morning. Let your spirit abide. And touch them now, Lord. Help them, Lord, to give glory to your name. Bless them to draw now. This is an evil day, Lord. Let your blessings flow in this hour, we pray. In Jesus' name. Lift your hands and shout hallelujah. Oh, shout hallelujah. Oh, shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Come on, pray. Come on, pray. Pray.
Thank you, Jesus.
You have stood before the Lord. You have raised your hands to the Lord. Saints, don't use the church as a game. Be for real in your heart. It doesn't matter what other folks think. What matters is, how do you receive God? Do you believe God's word? And in turn, God will bless you according to your faithfulness. We want you to prepare this time. We want you to give liberally. Give as God has blessed you to give. Give like God has given you to give. You want God to bless you more. Bless Him more.
Yes, sir.
Let us all stand as we prepare to receive tithing and offering this time. Heavenly Father, in thy precious name, as we prepare to bring forth tithing and offering, we ask you to look on the hearts of each one of your people. You understand what they need. And Lord, you know how the enemy has spoken to them. And we ask you, Lord, to talk to them, speak to their hearts. Bless them that they're able to give. And as they give, Lord, bless them to receive a return blessing abundantly, 60-fold, 100-fold,
yes,
over and over again.
Yes,
bless those that are giving. Bless those that have enough to give, we pray. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Amen. This time, please follow the directions of the ushers.